The internet contains zettabytes of information. That's 10 to the 21st bytes, or 1 billion terabytes. And in the years to come, that number is only going to grow. Our advancements in data-driven technologies, like artificial intelligence, will also require computers to achieve greater computation speeds than they have today. Currently, our data is stored in electronic devices using binary code, a select pattern of ones and zeros. To retrieve this data, applications are run to extract and process binary code and present the information in its original form. But this technology has its limitations, especially as we strive to design smaller devices. To tackle this problem, scientists are turning to alternative mechanisms of data storage, using biomolecules such as DNA and vast libraries of synthetic chemicals to develop innovative approaches to data storage and computation. DNA is a natural mechanism of data storage. It contains all the genetic instructions required for our bodies to grow and function. If DNA can store all our biological data, can it store our digital information too? Turns out, it can. Like binary code, DNA stores our genetic information through a sequence of base units, or nucleotides. Adenine, guanine, cytosine, and thymine. With four possible base units, data that normally requires two numbers of binary can be stored in one nucleotide. This means informaticians can encode twice the amount of information in DNA than as in binary. So far, scientists have been able to store entire books and music videos in DNA sequences. These digital and audio files are converted into binary code that is translated into specific sequences of nucleotides, a strand of DNA which is then freeze-dried. Once freeze-dried, this DNA and the information it contains can last for thousands of years. When the time comes to access the stored data, the DNA strands are sequenced and converted back into binary or any other base representation. Besides DNA storage, scientists are developing new molecular storage strategies using a wide variety of small molecules, including the small molecules that make up the metabolome. The metabolome is the complete set of all small and macromolecules in a biological system. Its diverse chemical composition makes it incredibly information dense. Think of all the complex processes that occur in your body at the molecular level. The makeup of your metabolome is the informational basis for all of these events. Based on this idea, scientists are creating extensive libraries of synthetic molecules that, like the metabolome, can be used to encode information, store it, and even execute complex data computations. With a mixture of these molecules dissolved in solution, scientists can retrieve information by analyzing the mixture with a special instrument. The readout from the instrument indicates the presence or absence of specific molecules. This information can be converted into a base representation system code, like binary, which a computer can interpret. For example, the presence of molecule A in a sample can be equated to a 1, while its absence is the equivalent of a 0 in binary. Referencing a pre-established library, the presence or absence of a molecule in a mixture represents one bit of information. A 4x4 weld plate with 16 unique mixtures of 4 molecules can then encode 64 bits of data. Imagine this process on a much larger scale, and you can get an idea of just how much data could be stored this way. Additionally, by understanding how these molecules will react in certain environments, scientists can apply different reaction conditions to change the data storing molecules in a manner akin to traditional computation. In this way, complex manipulations and calculations can be performed on data in a multidimensional space while it is stored in a very small volume of solution. This would allow for sophisticated parallel computing, enhanced pattern recognition, and improved search algorithms used by popular web services today. Once we are able to harness the storage and computing powers of small molecules like DNA and metabolites, we'll be able to contain more information in less volume, and our electronic devices will become even smaller than they are today.